वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर इन टू अवर सिक्स्थ लेक्चर ऑफ यूनिट वन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट मशीन डिज़ाइन, हुज सब्जेक्ट कोड इज़ ME204, एंड द टॉपिक विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टूडे इज द लिमिट्स, फिट्स एंड टॉलरेंसेज. आई एम श्री कृष्णा मिश्रा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सुरेश ज्ञान विहार यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर. And let's start with our today's lecture. First of all, have a look on the objectives of today's lecture. The lecture objectives of today's lecture are: we will get the understanding to apply the concept of limits, and the second objective is to study about the guidelines to be followed in fits and tolerances. The third objective is to know about few rules for giving fits and tolerances. And the next objective is to know about few rules for denoting limits. See, in machine design, there are some rules and guidelines given for denoting the fits and tolerances. So we are going to study about them all. First of all, we will know what is the meaning of these tolerances, what is fit, and then after the classification is there of fits and tolerances, we will study that, and then after how to denote that fits and tolerances, we will see. So let's move into our lecture now. Tolerance. First of all, we will know what is tolerance. Due to inaccuracy of manufacturing methods, it is not possible to machine a component to a given dimension. So the dimensions are manufactured in such a way that their dimensions lie between two limits, the maximum limit and the lower limit. Now the maximum, the basic dimension, here there is the term basic dimension. Let's see what is the meaning of this term basic dimension. The basic dimension is called the normal or basic size, while the difference between the two limits is called a permissible tolerance. See, there are inaccuracies in manufacturing methods. So due to the inaccuracy of manufacturing methods, it is never possible to machine a component to the given dimension. So the components are so manufactured that their dimensions lie between two limits, maximum limit and the minimum limit. The basic dimension is called the normal or basic size, while the difference between the two limit is called permissible tolerance. Tolerance is defined as permissible variation in the dimension of the component. The two limits are sometimes called the upper deviation and the lower deviations. All right, through with the help of figure, I will explain you which is the upper deviation and the lower deviation. First of all, the basic dimension is what? It is the normal size or the basic size. Basic size is known as the basic dimension. Basic size is known as basic dimension, normal size. While the difference between the two limit, the upper and the lower limit, the difference between the two limit is known as the permissible tolerance, is known as the permissible tolerance. And what is tolerance? Tolerance is defined as permissible variation in the dimension of the component. Permissible variation in the dimension of the component means it is permitted by the person who has given the order to manufacture to a company. He or she gives the tolerance limit also, that the product will be acceptable if it is up to this particular tolerance value. Alright, now the two limits are also sometimes called as the upper and the lower deviations. With the help of diagram, we will see now. As you can see in the diagram, that there is upper deviation. See, with the example of hole and shaft, you can understand the deviation because these two are the mating parts. Mating parts means one fits into the other. Shaft is also always inserted in the hole. So there is some tolerance. So this is the shaft tolerance. This is the shaft tolerance, this particular, and this is the hole tolerance. All right, this particular is the shaft and this is the hole tolerance. And what is the upper deviation for the hole? This particular length is known as the upper deviation for the hole. And what is the lower deviation for the hole? This is the lower deviation for the hole. All right, this is the lower deviation for the hole. Now for the shaft, let us see for the shaft what it is. For the shaft, as you can see, the lower deviation, this is the lower deviation. Now see, for the shaft, this is the lower deviation. This is the lower deviation of the shaft. All right, and what is the upper deviation? This is the upper deviation. This is the upper deviation. So you can see the upper deviation and lower deviations of the shaft. This is the, this particular is the lower deviation. This particular is the lower deviation. And this particular is the upper deviation. This particular small value is the upper deviation. So now I hope you have understood what is upper deviation and the lower deviation of shaft and hole. And the basic size, there is also one basic size, as I have told you by definition also, that what is basic size? What is basic size? Basic size, as I have told you by definition also, that what is basic size? Here in the previous slide itself I have told you, basic size is what? Is the normal dimension or the basic dimension. Alright, so here in the diagram you can see that upper deviation and lower deviation of shaft is given, and upper deviation and lower deviation of hole is also given. Then after, basic size is also mentioned here. This is the basic size. This is the basic size, and there is also one zero line is concerned. What is this zero line? This particular basic size line, the line of the basic size, this line is known as the zero line. This line is known as the zero line. This line is known as the zero line. All right. So, and there is schematic representation of shaft and hole. How the hole is represented? It is represented in this way. And how is the shaft represented? It is represented in this way. Means if there are hatching lines which are deviating towards the right, which are moving towards the right upwards, then we say they are the hole. And if the hatching lines are moving towards the, if these hatching lines are inclined towards the right downwards, then we say they are the shaft. So this is the schematic representation. All right, what was the upper deviation for hole? This was the upper deviation for hole. And lower deviation, this was the lower deviation of the hole. All right, and for the shaft, what was the lower deviation of shaft? This was the lower deviation of the shaft. And what was the upper deviation of shaft? This was the upper deviation of shaft. So you can see for shaft, the upper deviation is less than the lower deviation. And for hole, the upper deviation is higher than the lower deviations. Through side view also, you can see hole tolerance. This is the hole tolerance and this is the shaft tolerance. Now, coming into the next slide, there are basically two systems of specifications for tolerance. What are the two systems of specification of tolerance? Unilateral and bilateral tolerance. Unilateral and there are two system of specifications for tolerance, namely unilateral tolerance and bilateral tolerance. In unilateral tolerance system, one tolerance is zero, while the other takes care of all permissible variations in basic size. So what do you understand from that? See, in unilateral, one tolerance is zero, while the other take care of all permissible variation in the basic size. For example, as you can see here, in example, 100 plus 0.0 to 0.04. This means that the upper tolerance limit is 0.04 and the lower tolerance limit is 0.0. Means the upper value द अपर टॉलरेंस वैल्यू विल बी 100 100 प्लस 100 प्लस 0.04, वाइल द लोअर लोअर टॉलरेंस वैल्यू इज 100 प्लस 0.0. दिस मीन्स दैट द डायमेंशन कैन बी एनीवेयर बिटवीन 100. इफ यू एड दिस 100 प्लस 0.0 इट विल बिकम 100 एंड 100 to हाउ मच 100 टू 100 एंड 100.04. सो डायमेंशन, इफ द मैन्युफैक्चर्ड प्रोडक्ट हैज द डायमेंशन बिटवीन दीज टू 100 एंड 100.04, देन दिस इज एक्सेप्टेबल अकॉर्डिंग टू द टॉलरेंस गिवन हियर. Now this type of tolerance, this type of denoting tolerance, this type of system used for denoting tolerance is known as unilateral tolerance. Why it is known as unilateral tolerance? Because here one tolerance is zero. As you can see here, the lower limit is zero. The lower limit of tolerance is zero, while the upper limit has got some positive value. All right, it can be reverse of this also. How can it be reverse of this? As you can see, this is the second example of it. You can see in this second example, this one which I am highlighting with this red color, in this second example you can see that you have this upper limit equal to zero, means one of the tolerance limit is zero, while the other has got some value. Now since you can see, it can go into the negative side also, or it can go into the positive side also. But the common thing among these both of these is that you can see that one of the limit is zero. Here lower limit is zero and here higher limit is zero. So such type of tolerance where one tolerance is zero, such type of tolerance system in which one tolerance is zero while the other value takes care of all permissible variation in basic size is known as unilateral tolerance. Uni itself means single side of tolerance. So it is easy to remember also. If it is given uni, means there is only one side of the tolerance. All right, one of the tolerance will be zero. In unilateral tolerance, one of the tolerance is zero. Keep it in mind. Only this thing, that in unilateral tolerance, one of the tolerance limit, either the upper limit or the lower limit, that will be zero. Got the point? Now, in the case of bilateral tolerance, the variations are given in both the directions from normal size. Here, the variations are given in both the directions from the normal size. The upper limit in this case is the basic size plus non-zero positive tolerance. All right, the upper limit is the basic size plus the non-zero positive tolerance, and the lower limit is the basic size plus the non-zero negative tolerance plus the non-zero negative tolerance plus the non-zero negative tolerance. So for example, if 25 is the basic size, then what will be the upper limit? Upper limits will be written as something with positive sign. For example, if it is written plus 0.4, so this will become its upper limit. This will make its upper limit equal to 25.04. All right, and the lower limit if also along with this plus 0.4, if there is also one minus sign, this means that lower this 25.04 is the upper limit. And what will be the lower limit? For lower limit, you will have to minus 25. You will have to minus from 25 0.4. So when you will minus this 0.4 from 25, you will get some value. It will be equal to 20. It will be equal to how much? It will be equal to 24 point. It will be equal to how much? 24.6. So any value, any dimension of the product which lies between these two values, 24.6 to 25.04, is the permissible value. In this, 25.04 is the upper value and the lower limit value is 24.6. This is the lower limit value. Now this type of system in which we give the tolerance in both sides from the zero line, in both sides from the basic size, when we give the tolerance in both sides of the basic size, then we will say that this is bilateral tolerance. So what are bilateral tolerance? Bilateral tolerance, the example of bilateral tolerance are here in this way, 25 plus minus 0.4, or it can also be written in this way. If the values differ, if in the positive side and in the negative side, if in both the sides, in the both the direction from the zero line, if the values differ, then in that case we can write in this way, as it is written here. What it is written? It is written that 25, it is written as 25. All right, and in limits it is written to the power 0.-0.2, and here plus 0.4. in this way it is written. This means that the value permitted is between 25 plus 0.4, means 25.04. this is the upper limit. All right, students, and lower limit, for getting the lower limit, what you will do? You will minus 25 from 25, you will minus 0.2, so it will be equal to 24.8. So this way of denoting tolerance, in which there is positive value as well as negative value from the basic size, then this type of tolerance grade system is known as bilateral tolerance. Now the values in the positive and the negative direction can be same or it can be different, but both will be considered as bilateral tolerance. The last line, in bilateral tolerance, the two tolerances are often equal, but this is not a necessary condition. The two tolerances are often equal. Generally, it is written in this way. Oftenly, this is used, but this is not the only necessary conditions. It can be of this type also, as I have told you. Unilateral tolerances are used for shafts and holes. For the case of shafts and holes, we give unilateral tolerances. Generally, unilateral tolerances are preferred for whom? For the shafts and holes, because in shafts we can't give any upper deviation. Upper limit means upper limits will have to be zero for the case of shaft. While in the case of hole, lower limit has to be zero. Otherwise, there will be some interference fit. Now, what are these fits? Let's have a look on that. What are these fits? Coming into the next slide. Fits. What are fits? See, when two parts are to be assembled, the relationship from the difference between their sizes before assembly is called as fit. Whenever you assemble two parts, for example a nut and a bolt, if you assemble these two parts, then the relationship resulting from the difference between their sizes बिफोर असेंबली इज कॉल्ड एज फिट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, जनरल एग्जाम्पल आई एम टेकिंग, इफ यू हैव अ नट एंड अ बोल्ट, इफ फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू हैव अ बोल्ट लाइक दिस एंड ऑल्सो यू हैव अ नट लाइक दिस, ऑल राइट, सम वॉट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज ड्राॅइंग इज नॉट प्रॉपर, बट स्टिल आई होप यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड. वॉट इज दिस? दिस इज योर नट. वॉट इज दिस? दिस इज योर नट. ऑल राइट स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर नट. दिस इज वॉट? दिस इज योर नट एंड दिस इज योर बोल्ट. नाउ वॉट द फिट इज सेइंग टू यू, आइदर नट विल नॉट इंसर्ट इन टू, बोल्ट विल नॉट इंसर्ट इन टू द नट. If it doesn't insert into the nut, what we say? That there is some interference fit. All right. And now if the nut exactly fits into the bolt, into the shank portion of the bolt, this is the shank portion, this is the head of the bolt, this is known as the head, and this particular portion in which the nut is inserted in the threads, this is known as the shank portion of the bolt. This is known as the shank portion. So if exactly this nut fits into the bolt, exactly means exactly of the same dimension, if the hole in the nut is exactly of the same dimension as the diameter of the shank, then we say that there is a transition fit. All right. And if the nut is easily inserted in the shank of the bolt, if the nut is easily inserted in the shank of the bolt, then we say that there is some clearance, there is some clearance, there is some clearance fit. So basically, what is fit? What do you understand by fit? Fit is basically what? When the two parts are to be assembled, the relationship resulting from the difference between their sizes before assembly is called as fit. All right, fit is generally a common word, and this fit which you are standing here in the design, it is not very much different from that fit which you use in your daily life. Like in case of your clothes also, whenever something is very tight, we say that it is not fitting properly. So that situation in which our cloth is not fitting into the body, all right, it is extremely tight, even it is not going into our body, then we say that, in technical terms, we say that this is a interference fit. We say that it is a interference fit. We say that it is a interference fit. And if you are wearing a shirt that is exactly fitting into the body, means you can't breathe in it, but it has fitted, but it is not comfortable. So in that situation, you can compare with transition fit. All right, and if the shirt is very loose, means you have put on that shirt, you wore that shirt and it is very loose, and we say that there is, in technical terms, we can say that, you can relate it with this technical terms, that we can say that it is clearance fit. It is what? It is clearance fit. It is basically what? It is clearance fit. So as you see, everything is now clear to you. Now coming into the definitions of these three, generally the example is not taken of the nut and the bolt. The example is always taken of the shaft and the hole. Generally the example is always taken of the shaft, which has got some keyway here. Shaft which has got some keyway here. Shaft which has got some keyway here. And the hole, generally the example is taken of shaft and hole. Shaft and hole. All right. This is the hole, or you can say, if this is the hole and that is the shaft, so in this way the example is taken of the shaft and the hole. So depending upon the limits of the shaft and the hole, fits are broadly classified into clearance fit, transition fit, and the third is interference fit. Now In the case of interference fit, coming into the definition part of these, clearance fit. What is clearance fit? Clearance fit is a fit which always provide a positive clearance between the hole and the shaft over the entire range of tolerances. What is clearance fit? It is a type of fit which always provides a positive clearance between the hole and the shaft over the entire range of tolerance. Always there is some positive clearance, means there is gapping between the shaft and the hole. If there is gapping between the shaft and the hole, we say that there is clearance fit. Alright. In this case, tolerance zone of the hole is entirely above the shaft. Tolerance zone of the hole is entirely above the shaft. So there is no risk factor involved. Whole of the tolerance zone of the hole is above the shaft. So there is no chance of shaft not getting inserted inside the hole. Alright. Now, coming into the interference fit. Interference fit is a fit which always provides a positive clearance over the whole range of tolerance. What is interference fit? It provides a positive interference. Interference fit provides positive interference over the whole range of tolerance. Means everywhere over the entire shaft. The whole of the shaft, it is talking about the whole of the shaft. The whole of the shaft is not at all inserted inside the hole. The whole of the shaft, the complete shaft is not at all inserted anywhere. Means if this is the complete length of the shaft, not at any position it is inserted inside the hole. Then in that case, we say that there is some positive interference. There is some positive interference over the whole range of tolerance. Through example also, I have given you a shirt which is not at all getting into your body. This means that there is some positive interference. Positive interference means such type of fit is known as interference fit. In this interference fit, the tolerance zone of the hole, is completely below the shaft. In this case of interference fit, the tolerance zone of the hole is completely below that of the shaft. Alright, means here the tolerance zone of the hole is not at all above that of the shaft. Means if this is the shaft, then the tolerance zone of the hole will be in such a way that its upper limit as well as its lower limit both are below the basic size of the shaft. So therefore, since both are below the basic size of the shaft, then there is not a single chance that the shaft will insert into the hole. Coming into the transition fit. Transition fit is a fit which may provide either a clearance or interference depending upon the actual values of the individual tolerances of the meeting components. In this case, tolerance zone of the hole and the shaft overlap. Now in this case, it may either provide a clearance or the interferences depending upon the actual values of individual tolerance of the mating components. In this case, there might be that the upper limit of the upper tolerance value of the shaft is exactly equal to the lower tolerance value of the hole. Therefore, it may provide either a clearance or interference depending upon the actual values. All right, depending upon the actual values of the shaft and the hole. Now coming into a diagram, through a diagram this is shown. Now this is the diagram which is used for indicating the clearance fit, transition fit and interference fit. How it is denoted? See, in the diagram you can see these three positions are shown by shaft. As I have told you, these hatching lines which are going downwards towards right, these indicate what? These indicate shaft. These indicate shaft. So the three blocks are made here. Three blocks are used for explaining you the fits. The first one, clearance fit. Now this is the hole position. This from here to here, this is the hole position. This is the hole position, means holes are indicated by hatch lines which are moving upwards towards the right, which are moving upwards towards the right. So these are hole position, means this is the hole, this complete bigger length. All right, this is the hole. Now if a situation is such that can you guess which is the situation where there is clearance fit? This one, first situation, means shaft and hole both are having a gapping between them. Shaft and hole both are having a gap between them, means shaft is easily inserted between the hole. So the first situation, this situation is what? This situation is clearance fit. This is indicates the clearance fit. This indicates the clearance fit. And coming into the interference fit, extreme right means the C1. Now coming into this extreme right one, this one. Now here you can see that shaft, this is the zero line. This is zero line means what? This is zero line is the basic size. It denotes the basic size. So from the zero line, shaft is above and the hole is smaller. Means if this is the situation, that if this is the zero line and shaft hole is smaller than this zero line and shaft is greater in dimension than this zero line, then they can never insert inside each other. Means the third situation is of how, of what? The third situation is of interference fit. All right, now in between this option A, that is clearance fit, and the option C, that is interference fit, there is a situation which is known as transition fit. What is transition fit? In transition fit, you can see there can be three cases. Means either this can be the situation, means shaft, upper limit of shaft is above the lower limit of the hole. All right, and it can be this also, that upper limit of the shaft is smaller than the lower limit of the hole, or it can be in this way, that both upper limit and the lower limit both are in this way. So these things are clear to you now. Clearance fit, transition fit and interference fit. Now what is the hole basis system? There is a word hole basis system. This is also used. So you should have the knowledge of this also. What is hole basis system? There are two basic systems for giving tolerance to the shaft and the hole. Namely the hole basis system and the shaft basis system. There are two basic systems for giving tolerance to the shaft and the hole. The hole basis system and the shaft basis system. You can give tolerance by using any of this system. In the hole basis system, the different clearances and interferences are obtained by associating various shaft with a single hole. In hole basis system, what you do? The different clearances and interferences are obtained by associating various shaft with the single hole whose lower deviation is zero. Now this, keep in mind that in hole basis system, the lower deviation of hole is zero. So you can understand, if this is the hole, if this is the complete gapping of the hole. All right, so its lower deviation is 0 means its lower limit is 0. Its lower limit is 0. It cannot go less than that. It cannot go less than that. But there is some upper deviation. It cannot go, the hole can't go less than that. So that is known as the hole basis system. Here the different clearances and interferences are obtained by associating various shaft with a single hole whose lower deviation is 0. All right. Also in this case, the size of the shaft, the size of the hole is the basic size. In this case, the size of the hole is considered as the basic size, means size of the hole is not altered. The size of the hole is not changed. It will be exactly of the same dimension. There will be no tolerance, or if there is tolerance, there will be no lower deviation of this hole. And the clearance or interference is applied to the shaft dimension. And whatever is the clearance or the interference, that is done on shaft dimension. All right. Also, the system of hole basis system is denoted by capital H. The system of hole basis system is denoted by capital H. I hope you are getting what is a hole basis system. In hole basis system, basically, first of all, there are two basic systems for giving tolerances to the shaft and the hole. And what are the name of these two basic systems? The hole basis system and the shaft basis system. In the hole basis system, what you do, the lower deviation of a hole is considered as 0, and the different clearances and interferences are obtained by associating various shaft with a single hole, while also in this hole basis system, the size of the hole is the basic size and the clearance or interference is applied to the shaft dimension. Clearance or the interference is applied to the shaft dimension, is applied to the shaft dimension. All right. In this case, the name of this hole basis system is what? It is denoted by capital H. So this was your hole basis system. Coming into the shaft basis system, what is the shaft? First of all, a diagram which shows you the hole basis system. You can see here, as you can see, the hole dimension is not at all changed. If the change is there, that is in the shaft, it only. This system has an advantage over shaft basis system. What is the advantage? Because holes are machined by standard drills or reamers having fixed dimensions, while the shafts can be turned grounded to any dimension. So this is an asset. But the preparing a hole is a difficult thing because there are some standard drills or reamers for that. But a shaft can be machined or turned to any given dimension. So this is a preferred type of system, hole basis system. And due to this reason, the hole basis system is widely used. In this diagram, you can see this shows the clearance fit shaft. This shows the interference fit and this shows the transition fit. You can see that in the hole dimension is not changing in any of the three, only the shaft is changing. In this, the shaft is of the less dimension as compared to hole. Here the shaft is of more dimension as compared to hole, and here the shaft exactly fits into the hole. So this is the diagram which shows you the hole basis system. Now coming into the shaft basis system. In the shaft basis system, the different clearances or interferences are obtained by associating various holes with a single shaft whose upper deviation is 0. In the shaft basis system, what is shaft basis system? In the shaft basis system, what happens? The different clearances or interferences are obtained by associating various holes with a single shaft whose upper deviation is 0. Now, in this case of shaft basis system, द अपर डेविएशन ऑफ द शाफ्ट इज कंसिडर्ड एज जीरो. द अपर डेविएशन ऑफ शाफ्ट इज जीरो मीन्स यू कॉन्ट कीप द अपर डेविएशन मोर द यू कॉन्ट कीप द साइज ऑफ द शाफ्ट मोर देन दिस वैल्यू ऑफ अपर डेविएशन. यू कॉन्ट इंक्रीज द साइज ऑफ द शाफ्ट. द शाफ्ट साइज कैन बी डिक्रीज बट यू कॉन्ट इंक्रीज द साइज ऑफ द शाफ्ट दैट इज फिक्स्ड. ऑल राइट. So here therefore it is written that the different clearances or interferences are obtained by associating various holes with a single shaft. All right. Now I will show you a figure where this principle is associated. In this system, the size of the shaft is the basic size while the clearance or interference is applied to the dimensions of hole. Now here shaft size is not altered, only the hole size is changed with respect to the size of the shaft. It is denoted by that this shaft basis system is denoted by small h. This shaft basis system is denoted by small h and hole basis system was denoted by capital H. Now the shaft basis system is popular in industries using semi-furnished, semi-finished or finished shafting such as bright bars as raw material. So it is also used but not that much widely used as compared to hole basis system. It is popular where in industries which uses semi-finished or finished shafting. So these were the hole basis system and the shaft basis system. This is the diagram of the shaft basis system. You can see that this is the shaft. Its dimension is not changing. In clearance fit, the hole is greater than the shaft. In interference fit, the hole is smaller than the shaft, therefore it doesn't fit. And in the transition fit, it can be anywhere between these two, one, second and third. So this was your basis system, tolerance systems. Now this is the BIS system of fits and tolerances. According to the system recommended by BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards, tolerance is specified by a alphabet, capital or small, followed by a number. Means it can either be specified in this way or this way. If capital means it denotes, as we have studied, that if capital alphabet is written, then it means hole basis system, and if it is small, then it is the shaft basis system. And the number is written just after this alphabet. The description of tolerance consists of two parts, fundamental deviation and the magnitude of tolerance. So first, this alphabet shows you the fundamental deviation, and the second, this digit shows you the magnitude of tolerance. The fundamental deviation gives the location of tolerance zone with respect to zero line. It is indicated by a alphabet, capital letters for hole and small letters for shaft. The magnitude of tolerance is designated by a numbers which is known as grade. The magnitude is denoted by a number. The magnitude of tolerance is denoted by the number, which is also called as grade. So this is the zero line, students. And the fundamental deviation is considered. This is considered as the fundamental deviation. And it is denoted by this capital H, capital alphabet or small alphabet. Apart from that, there is some magnitude also given to you, which is also named as grade. So grade is, this is the grade. All right. So there are two parts in designating any tolerance. First is the fundamental deviation and second is the magnitude. For shaft we use capital letter and for hole we use small letters. The grade of tolerance is defined as the group of tolerance which are considered to have the same level of accuracy for all the basic sizes. There are total 18 grades of tolerances. All right, and its names are IT1, IT2, where IT is what? International tolerance. The, for example, the tolerance of a shaft 50 mm diameter as the basic size with the fundamental deviation denoted by G and the tolerance of the grade 7 is written by 50G7, where 50 is the basic size, G is the... So the fit is indicated by the basic size common to both components followed by a symbol for tolerance of each component. Means for shaft and hole, if the basic size is 50, so 50 is written and it is followed by a symbol for tolerance of each component. For hole, this is the tolerance and this is the for shaft. So it is written either in this way or this way, or it can be written in this way. So this is all about tolerance, limits and fits. I hope you have understood everything about this. Now coming into some multiple choice questions to assess our understanding about this concept. Multiple choice question number 1. In a bilateral system of tolerance, the tolerance is allowed on, we all know that in bilateral system, the tolerance is allowed on both sides of the nominal size. So it can be, this is D is the correct answer. Coming into the second MCQ, in a unilateral system of tolerance, the tolerance is allowed on, in unilateral system, uni means one side only. So tolerance is allowed only on one side, means one side of nominal size. So this is the B is the correct answer. Coming into MCQ number 3, a basic shaft is one whose whose upper deviation is 0 or lower deviation is 0. For a shaft, lower upper deviation is 0. So a shaft whose upper deviation is 0 is known as basic shaft. Then a basic hole is what? A basic hole is one whose lower deviation is 0. So a basic hole is one whose lower deviation is 0. So here option A is the correct answer. Coming into the MCQ number 5. According to Indian standard, the total number of tolerance grades are 18. So C is the correct answer. Coming into MCQ number 6. Now 100H6G5. This means that what is the answer? See, 100 is the basic size, 6 is the hole tolerance gate for hole, and 5 is the tolerance gate for shaft. So I think this is first is giving you the correct answer. So A is the correct answer. Coming into the next MCQ. When two parts are to be assembled, the relationship resulting from the difference between their sizes before assembly is called as, we have understood this, already studied, fits. It is known as fits. So C is the correct answer. Then a fit which always provides a positive clearance between the hole and the shaft over the entire range of tolerance is known as, we all know, we have studied it, this clearance fit is the fit which provides positive clearance. So B is the correct answer. Coming into the next MCQ, MCQ number 9. The tolerance zone of the hole is completely below that of the shaft in case of, now the tolerance zone is below that of the shaft in case of, we all know that in clearance fit, you have the tolerance zone of the hole below that of the shaft. So B is the correct answer. Coming into the MCQ number 9. In hole basis system, the shaft of the hole is the basic size. The size of the hole is the basic size. Alright, so you can see the size of the hole is the basic size in case of what? The option you can see that in the hole basis system, the size of the hole is the basic size. So A is the correct answer. So all the MCQs are solved. You go through all these MCQs and the concept, and you want, if you want some extensive study regarding this topic, so you can get the content for more learning. You can get the content from the references also. These are the references. You can go through any of the content of any of this book. The most content which I have used is from this V.B. Bhandari book, which is of Design of Machine Element by Tata McGraw-Hill Publication. Apart from that, there are other books also. You can see in the screen, Shingle book, again from McGraw-Hill Publication, Machine Element, Mechanical Engineering Design. That is also a good book. So any of the book you can refer. So that's all in today's lecture. I hope you have understood everything taught today. Thank you and have a nice day.